Hello friends, in my last session we have seen the two methods, direct method and indirect method or iterative method. So today we are going to study with the direct method, which is a Gauss elimination method. So today I'll try to cover Gauss elimination and Gauss-Jordan in the same video, otherwise a separate video. So let us understand the concept of what do we do in Gauss elimination and what do we do in Gauss-Jordan. So suppose we have three equations and a constant. So if I try to make, you know, as Cramer's rule, if I try to take the coefficients, for example, a11, a12, a13, a14 are the coefficients of my first equation, then second, third, fourth. So here if I make a triangles, okay, suppose A is my matrix. So if I make a triangle, then this is a lower triangle, this is an upper triangle. Okay, and this is the diagonal elements. Let us say diagonal elements are a11, a22, a33, a44. So I can make either lower triangular elements as zero or I can make upper triangular elements as zero. Okay, so in case of Gauss elimination method, by applying some logic, we can make lower triangular elements as zero. Okay, suppose we make lower triangular elements as zero, then we can directly have a44. Okay, this is equal to some constant, so we can get directly the value of a44. If I put this value here, and I will get a33, then a22, then a11. Likewise, I can solve it for x, y, or what, p, q, r, s. This is for four equations I am saying, but we are going to solve the three equations simultaneously. So in our case, the matrix will be of 3 by 3, and we will get a11, a22, a33 or x, y, z. Okay, so this is what we are doing in Gauss elimination. So in Gauss elimination, we have to eliminate either upper triangular or lower triangular. Okay, any one of it we are eliminating, means making it zero. And in case of a Gauss-Jordan elimination method, understand the difference. Gauss-Jordan elimination method, we are making both the triangles as zero. Upper triangular matrix also we are doing zero, lower triangular also we are doing zero, and only diagonal elements we are keeping as it is. So directly we will get the value of x, y, and z if it is 3 by 3 matrix for three equations. So this is a basic logic behind Gauss elimination and Gauss-Jordan elimination. I hope you have understood. If not, please comment me.